In this vlog, we will try to see the implementation of an interesting topic which so many people of you have requested before. So that is uploading an image from our Flutter application. And yes, we have successfully uploaded an image from Android device and iOS device as well, and we have got the same output, and also we have cleared the image and try to re-upload the image. So I hope this is a clear tutorial for you to understand the concept of uploading the image. So Violet, let's get started. So previously we have seen many examples regarding the network calls, like we have seen post and get methods, and now we will be making use of a post call and try to upload an image to the server. So now here we are trying to add a dependency here, so it's HTTP dependency I'm going to add here. So currently I'm not providing any version, but you may provide the latest version available. So now after adding our dependency, you need to get the dependencies, and yes, now we are good to go. So here I am just importing the material.dart package, and here we are declaring void main, and inside which we are providing run app, and here we are specifying our default app, my app here. So we are going to create a stateless widget my app, which is going to return a material app, and here inside the home we are going to declare a scaffold, and these are all the basic things which I think you might have understood following our previous tutorials as well. But as we are trying to do this tutorial for even a novice, a beginner, to understand, so I'm just following every step from scratch again. So here I'm just providing the title like image upload, and we are going to consider a body inside which we are going to consider a container. Why? Because I just have a button, that's all, nothing more than that. So I just want a single child layout here, so that's what I am choosing, a container. In a real-time application you might require a column or row depending upon your requirement, and here I am specifying a text button for which we have on press, and we are going to declare an anonymous function for it, and we also have a child. So here we are going to provide the label for our button with the help of a text widget. So I'm just going to provide like upload. And here one more thing I wanted to explain you here is, like, in this particular tutorial I'm going to upload an image that we provide in our assets folder here. So currently we don't have an assets folder, and let's go ahead and create one. So here I'm going to create an assets folder. So our assets folder is being created, and now I'm going to add an image here. So it's a just sample image which I have created for this tutorial, and the name is like test image. And now if you have gone through our previous tutorials, you might have already known what is the next step here. Yes, we need to add the assets here. So if you are having any query regarding this indentation, just make sure it is in the line of user's material design here. So just follow it and see, it lies in the same position. And also just remove this, and I'm going to provide assets slash test image dot png, and don't forget to specify the format and everything as well. So if you are having multiple images, you may even just specify the folder here, and even that works. But as I have only one image, I'm trying to provide the complete path here. So now we have added something into our pubspec file, so we need to fetch those dependencies here to make sure our code gets the assets which we have added, and now we are going to create a method like upload image, and this method will have two parameters. So one is title, so the title for the image, and one more is, so don't worry what the file is like, we need to import this .io. So with the help of this file, we are going to provide the path for our image, and that particular image will be uploaded. So here we are going to create a variable request, and with the help of HTTP which we have added at the starting of the tutorial in PubSpec, so we are just making use of it. So here make sure you import this HTTP which you have specified there. So import HTTP, this is our package, and also you can just specify like as HTTP. You need not specify everything every time, so you can just make use of HTTP here, and you can make use of the methods available in that particular dependency. So if you are facing any queries in this particular step, do let me know in the comment section below, I will surely help you with it. So now we are trying to make use of multipart request here, and also I will let you know what is multipart file, we will be using the same in this tutorial also. So multipart request, and here the first thing you hear, you can see it is suggesting us method, and the second one is URI. So the method we are going to make use is post, and URL is, I'm going to provide. So you are getting some error here, right? So the argument type string can't be assigned here to the parameter type URI. Yes, it's showing us a suggestion that you need to use URI here to provide the URL path here. So URI dot pass, and here we are trying to provide the URL inside this. So here I'm making use of imgur.com, and you can just go through that particular website and sign up for it, and you can also practice this particular tutorial by making use of your authentication, that is client ID over there. You can use your own API for which you want to upload the image with the help of the post method here. So now with the help of this request here, you can add fields. So here we can specify the fields like key value pairs which we use mostly while we are passing some parameters in the post method. So here we can just pass the title which we have provided here, and equal to, I'm just providing some static values for now. So I'm just providing like dummy image, and here you can also customize your header section. And yes, we require this for this particular tutorial because we need to provide the client ID here, so you need to make use of the headers also here. And also in our coming tutorials we will be seeing how to upload multiple files, so we can just make use of files here. But in this particular tutorial we are making use of only one file, so we are not considering this option for now, that is files. So just make use of header, and here I'm going to provide authorization. And here what is the header required for that particular API, you need to provide that particular key name here, and I just provided authorization as an example. And here I'm going to provide a client ID, so that client ID I have signed up and I have got my own client ID, so I will be providing that at last. And I suggest you to sign up to this particular website, or else if you are having your own API, just make sure you add your own headers and fields depending upon your requirement. So now we have provided the API and we have provided the parameters for it, and now let's try to fetch the image and try to push it to this API. So we are going to create one more variable picture, and you can just provide any name here. And now by making use of HTTP multipart file dot, and here you can just make use of from bytes, from path, from string depending upon your requirement. For now I am making use of from bytes for this particular tutorial, and here is a field. So now let's provide the field to be image and value. So here to specify the value, we need to fetch the data and we need to process it. So we need to wait for a while and now make this method as asynchronous so that we can add await here and specify root bundle using which we need to load the image which we have specified in assets test image dot buffer dot as uint 8 list. Let's specify the file name here. So again, the file name here, I'm just trying to provide some static file name. I'm just providing the same name which we are having, like test image dot png. So now we need to add the multipart which we have specified here. We need to add the multipart to our request here, request dot files, and here we need to add our multipart file, that is picture. And now we need to fetch the response, so for which we are declaring a variable response. So we need to wait for a while to fetch our response here, and with the help of request we need to call send method so that we will fetch the response and we will be storing that response in this particular variable now. So now we need to process our response. So we need to add a variable like response data, and here you need to fetch the response dot stream, and here you need to convert that one to bytes. So now we'll be making use of this particular response data and create one more variable, and we can just provide it like result here. So this is a final output which we also try to print to the screen and show the result. So I'm just specifying it as a result. So string dot from character quotes, and you need to provide response data here. And now finally you can just make use of the print statement and try to print the response onto the console. So here we are considering an image from the assets folder. We have added the image in our assets folder and we have specified the same in the pubspec file. In the onpress anonymous function, you need to specify the upload image here, and title, you need to specify some title image, and file, you need to specify file here. So the actual path is like assets slash test image dot png. Make sure you have provided the exact path here. Now it will only accept a file format here, provide the path inside it, and now try to run this code. So first of all, we will try to run this code in Android emulator. So here our application is now installed onto this Android device, and now we can see the upload button here, and just try to make it to the center of the screen. So I'm just wrapping it with center and try to reload it. So here you can see our button is now in the center of the screen, and when you tap on this button, we will try to upload the image to the particular API which we have specified. So I have added my secret key, that is client ID, in the header section. And if you sign up in that particular website, you will fetch your own client ID, and please make sure you add it before trying this particular tutorial, because if you don't have your client ID, you can't upload the image. And now try to see the image once here. So this is the image which we are trying to upload, and now let's try to tap on the upload button and see the response here. So here you can see we have successfully uploaded our image, and this is the response which we have got. And now try to copy this particular URL and open a browser, and here try to paste this URL and just try to remove the slashes, extra slashes, and now try to run this. And here you can see we have got the image successfully uploaded from our Flutter application here. And now we will try to remove this particular image. So there is an API for deleting also, for deleting the image which you have uploaded, and for which you need to make use of this delete hash here. And from postman I am trying to provide this hash, and previously I have also tried this and it was working fine method like delete. And now try to run this code, and here you can see we have got success. And now again try refresh this particular image now and see, and here you can see the image you are requesting does not exist. So we have deleted this particular image from the server. And now let us try to make use of the same tutorial and try to run in an iPhone now. And here our application is now being successfully installed on iOS device, and here you can see the output is almost same. And now let's try to run it in our iOS device and see the output whether this works the same. And when you tap on the upload button, and here also we have got the same response, like our image is now successfully uploaded. And now try to run this, try to copy this URL, and here you can observe the file name. Previously when we have tried to upload the image from Android also we have got an URL. So in the iOS also we have got a URL. So this makes that the code works same. And here you can see we have got the same image uploaded again to the server. And now try to delete the image again by making use of the postman here. So I am just trying to provide the delete hash every time, and I am trying to call this API, and we will try to make use integrate the delete option also in our application as well by making use of this particular API call in our coming tutorials. And make sure you save these values by making use of a shared preference. And here you can see we have provided a title like dummy image, and that was being uploaded successfully to our server. And likewise you can make use of these parameters and provide your own requirements here. And now just like we have checked previously after deleting the image, now let's try to refresh the image again. And here you can observe the image you are requesting does not exist. And yes, we have successfully uploaded an image from Android device and iOS device as well, and we have got the same output. And also we have cleared the image and try to re-upload the image. So I hope this is a clear tutorial for you to understand the concept of uploading the image from Flutter application. So the code for this tutorial I am providing in the description section below. And if you are having any queries in the implementation, do let me know in the comment section below. And for more interesting tutorials like this, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.